Hello everyone! In today's video, I'll be showing you the upgraded version of my wire ring roller. It's the first time in a while I'm using my own voice, so please excuse any roughness in my accent. I hope it feels more personal than an AI voice like many are using today. Now, onto the build, let's get started. There are two changes. One, I eliminated the need for the two guiding smooth rods in the adjusting jaws. Two, I've been talking about it with people using the current version and they said it could use some form of vertical adjustment for the big rolling pin. So I thought about it and added that too. My first attempt at removing the guides and relying on plastic only failed. The jaws were unstable and were rocking back and forth. My second attempt had more lateral support, but the new plastic guides were not long enough, leaving room for side-to-side misalignment. So I lengthened the guides to the max and now everything is rock solid while still allowing for adjusting the distance between the jaws. Now let's start putting it together. I'll start the assembly with the rolling pin bearing block. I'm installing the bearings using a simple but effective method, pressing the block onto one bearing, then onto the other. Then I'm installing the driving roller pin. It's something between a slide fit and a press fit. Next, I'm installing two socket head screws to use the heads as aligning pins to match corresponding recesses in the base. This is the base. I pre-installed the lock nuts in their corresponding recesses. Over the base comes the wedge. The base and the wedge share an aligning feature to help keep everything in place while the wedge can slide along the base. Next, I'm aligning the bearing block over the base and wedge, using those two socket head screws as aligning features. And then I'm installing the screws to secure everything in place. Here I'm preparing the long threaded rods by attaching some nice knobs for ease of use. Finally, these are the reciprocating jaws, basically a pair of fancy bearing blocks for the U-groove bearings this ring roller uses to help keep the wire aligned. I'm using some 3D printed spacers to bring the bearings back into symmetry as they come asymmetrical from the factory. And then using some more socket head screws to secure the bearings into their places. With the first one done, the second one is exactly the same deal. The jaws are coming together like this. Now, to keep them reciprocating at all times, I'm using a small herringbone gear that I'm securing with another socket head screw. In this particular case, the screw's head also functions as a smooth bearing surface or as a solid axle for the gear. Much sturdier than a 3D printed feature, don't ask how I know. I'm adjusting the screw tension just right. Not too tight. Not too loose. This seems just about right. Now to put the bearing blocks in. I'm carefully aligning the last tooth on each unit to the center line I designed on the gear. This will ensure perfect alignment with the center of the unit. In this new version, I also added a thumb wheel for the big driving roller. This can come in handy when you want to drive the wire without touching it. It squeezes onto the shaft like a hose clamp. And then I mount the shaft onto the big bearing block. We are almost there. Now I'm putting in the two M5 threaded rods with washers to prevent wear. They will mate with M5 nuts on the other end. And now you can see why I tend not to show you how I'm installing the nuts. It's a real pain if I want them to not be too loose. Anyway, this is the unit ready. I put it on two boxes to raise it up to the camera without messing up the framing. You can always just press the two jaws together and then just tighten the screw easily. Just as you can always tighten the screw for finer control. The same goes for the wedge. You can push it and then tighten the threaded rod more easily. I left the driving roller for last just to allow for better visibility while showing the adjustments. The roller can always be installed with the thumb wheel in the back. Or without a thumb wheel at all, it's all a matter of preference. Here I'm showing again the action of adjusting the rolling pin's height by way of advancing the wedge. Before anything, I need to loosen the two bolts to allow for the height increase. Here's a sped up tightening just to show the available resulting range. Not shown here, once I'm satisfied with the new height, I must retighten those two bolts. Now let's see it in action. I'll start with the shameless plug. I'm unboxing one of my wire straighteners ready for shipping, just to show how I am processing the wire to be smooth before rolling it. As you can see, I'm starting with a pretty crooked length of wire, in this case 2 mm or 12 gauge wire. Normally I'd be pulling the wire instead of pushing as I'm doing here. But it was easier for me to perform it this way under the camera. Anyway, the wire gets straightened out pretty quickly. After a second pass, it's already good to go. Oh yeah, smooth as butter. And there it is in action, here working on a bigger radius band. And tightening to reduce the radius, then working the wire again to and fro. and tightening again even more for an even smaller radius. Here I am rolling it from the thumbwheel behind without touching the wire. Let's go for an even tighter radius. Oh man, I love how smooth this works. Well, this is it. I'll also put this new version up for sale on my site. Links will be in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye!